This is the award-winning Lee Pitts Live.
Brought to you by the North Law Firm. For car accidents and negligent security cases, call Joe at 239-337-1191. And by Lee Health.
Southwest Florida, welcome back. We're so thrilled to get Carrie here from the Human Services. Welcome to Lee Pitts Live.
Thank you so much. I'm glad to be here.
In a nutshell, what does your department do?
Human Services in Charlotte County does a whole lot of things, but essentially our job is to take care of those who maybe something's gone wrong. So there are some needs there that they may have. So we can help sort of shore some things up. So we look at housing, we look at senior services for senior citizens, we look at family services, help to pay bills, that sort of thing. Mm. But we also have an entire department dedicated to veteran services. So we have 211, we have a variety of things that we do, but our intention is just to help people who need it.
I know you're excited about Together Charlotte. What
yes.
is that?
Together Charlotte is a group of folks that came together a couple of years ago now, really stakeholders across the community, business leaders, health and human service providers, and a whole lot of citizens, about 50 folks, came together to really address and look at what are the needs here in Charlotte County when it comes to health and human services, and how can we come together to address them in a really holistic, fundamental way.
So you guys, from that, you put together a report.
Yes.
Wrote a report.
Yes. Expound. We just finished and published a report on housing. And really what we decided to do was we wanted to look at housing because obviously that's a huge piece of health and human services and really well-being. You need to have a place to live. And so what we did was a bunch of us came together and we constructed a report to dig into it. And we decided to focus on affordable housing mm-hmm. because housing that is not affordable, the market takes care of. So what we found is by 2025 in Charlotte County, we need just shy of 11,000 new households built. But about half of those need to be affordable.
And who are some of the people like law enforcement officers, school
Certainly.
Teachers? They would need affordable.
Absolutely, but also we would look at bus drivers, lunch ladies, people that work in service industry positions, so hotels, restaurants. In our community, we have a large service industry driven economy. And so we have a lot of folks who are working really hard, but who maybe are not quite making ends meet. Mm-hmm. And so what that results in is people being cost burdened when it comes to housing. And when people are paying more than 30% of their gross income on housing, it makes them more vulnerable to any kind of changes that happen. You know, a car accident, a loss of a job, anything like that. They are, you know, it becomes very unstable, and that can be a slippery slope. And then we might see them in my office or some of the other nonprofits in the community. So it's incredibly important that we help bolster those folks so that they are stable.
I would think that would be a factor, too, in attracting people to live in Charlotte
Absolutely.
County.
Absolutely.
To live and work in your workforce and your tax roll and all those types of things go.
That's exactly right. And what we find in our community is we have an interesting makeup here. We have, you know, retirees, people over the age of 65 are the highest or the fastest growing part of our population. So those that are working, we find that it's a smaller percentage. We've only got 42% of folks in our workforce, and a typical average in a normal community is about 62%.
I see.
So we have a very small workforce, and we have an awful lot of retirees. So we really need to drill in to what are the needs of that workforce, and how do we meet those needs? Because what we certainly don't want to create is a situation where people can't move here because they can't afford it, and then what we'll see is a big opening in terms of jobs. We're not going to be able to fill them.
Mm-hmm. I think you mentioned, was it 2000 and what? 2000 was a 5
by
years.
By 2025.
2025. Let's go to 2025.
Yep.
If all that study comes to reality mm-hmm. in 2025, Charlotte County. What are some key things that will have taken place in Charlotte County?
So a few things will have had to have happened there. So as I mentioned, about half of the houses that are needed will happen with the market. So we know we're going to have about 5,000 or 6,000 households naturally because of the market that will just be here because of our population growth. But the, what we focused on there was that affordable housing, because it doesn't happen without intervention, mm-hmm. government intervention, mm-hmm. because it's simply not affordable for developers or, you know, builders to build quote-unquote affordable housing. They can't make money. So what it takes then is a community effort, and also we need to work with the state, we need to work with local government, we need to work with local stakeholders, and really get creative in terms of nonprofits. We need to look at what are some different strategies, and that's what this report was. We identified 20 different strategies that we can undertake.
How can people get their hands on the report, and what are some key factors they should look for in the report?
Well, the website is togethercharlotte.org, which people are welcome to do. They can also, they're welcome to attend our meetings, which we do have stakeholder meetings. We also are going to be participating in a breakfast that is being held by the Gulf Coast Partnership on February 1st. They can buy tickets to that, where we'll be discussing more about the work that we're doing. But in essence, really what we need is we need people to join the conversation. This isn't easy stuff, you know, and oftentimes people can have a reaction to quote-unquote affordable housing. People can get nervous about what that means and what that looks like for their own neighborhood. But affordability is, it's all subjective. Mm-hmm. What's affordable to you and what's affordable to me are two different things. Most importantly, what this report does is create a common language around housing.
What next?
Yeah, so now what we really need to do is to put those recommendations into practice. We really need to put our money where our mouth is and begin to do that heavy lifting and that work. One of the first things that we want to do is reach out to the folks in Tallahassee. We'd like them to really stop sweeping the Sadowski Fund, mm-hmm. Which is earmarked money for affordable housing in communities. But it's that kind of thing where really it's an all hands on deck, mm-hmm. and we need to put all of this into practice, and it's not just government that does that, that's everybody.
And we have your information appearing on the screen throughout the interview. When you say we need to have Tallahassee stop messing around with the Sadowski
Act. Yeah, the Sadowski Fund. Yeah.
All right, so are you basically appealing to the public, mm-hmm. to make a phone call or do something to...
Yes.
stand up and be counted.
Absolutely.
How do they go about that?
Well, there are a variety of ways. You can certainly get in touch with your elected officials, but more importantly, what we'd like is for people to come and sit with us to mm-hmm. have these difficult conversations, right? I mean, this stuff isn't necessarily bedtime reading, right. Or maybe it is, depending on what you need to go to bed. But the idea is that we need to come together in a way where it's more than just people that work in health and human services. It's going to take all of us with our unique perspective to begin to sit down and to really talk to each other about these needs.
Charlotte County is in the growth mode. You are looking to
yes.
grow. You're not looking to stay status quo.
No. No, we have to, and, you know, for us to be a vibrant community mm-hmm. and to meet the needs. I mean, so anticipated in our report, what we looked at is by 2035, we're anticipating a 46% increase in people over the age of 65.
I'm excited about that myself.
They come with needs, mm-hmm. and so we really need to be ahead of the curve.
Well, Carrie, we're just fortunate to have you keeping an eye on the prize. And being a part of a push, keeping the agenda in front of people, and together, Charlotte, we commend y'all and everybody associated with that and what they've done.
Thank you very much for having me. It's a great group. I'm delighted.
And we're looking forward to getting you back and keeping us posted.
Excellent.
In 2025, I still should be around.
Oh, yeah. I bet you will.
As the saying goes on this particular show, for those who say it can't be done, they're usually interrupted by those like Carrie and all the fine people and the human services for the Charlotte County government who are doing it.
Lee Pitts Live is a Lee Pitts Enterprise production.
Hi, everybody. Thanks for watching Lee Pitts Live. Of course, I'm Lee Pitts, the host of Lee Pitts Live. We're here at the Holiday Inn Airport in Fort Myers, and I want you to continue to watch Lee Pitts Live on television, on YouTube, and, of course, listen to us on radio. But to get all of your shows to come right to you, just click on that subscribe button right there, and Lee Pitts Live will come right to you, your time, your way. That's Lee Pitts Live.